The Fida instrument is based on flow-induced dispersion analysis. It is a technology that allows you to measure size of molecules and small changes in molecular size in solution. This provides you with a number of important advantages when developing PROTACs and similar constructs. It allows you to measure four key parameters: the size and integrity of the protein of interest and the E3 ligase, binding affinities, including cooperativity for the formation of the ternary complex, direct in-solution measurement of the ternary complex, and last but not least, the fraction of the protein of interest which is found in the ternary complex.
I will give you a brief introduction to how this is done. Initially, we place labeled protein of interest in the Fida 1, and just 3 minutes later, you know the hydrodynamic radius of the protein of interest. As a control, you may also analyze the protein of interest in the presence of E3. If the size changes, it indicates that the protein of interest will also bind without the PROTAC. Next, you may verify the size of the unlabeled E3 with our intrinsic fluorescence detector. Now you are ready to check the formation of the ternary complex. It is simple, you just titrate your PROTAC candidates against your protein of interest in the presence of the E3 ligase. Place your samples in the instrument, and in a few minutes you will see data on how the apparent hydrodynamic radius changes as the ternary complex is formed. Running a full titration series will result in a bell-shaped curve like these. With the multiple binding affinities, standard fitting equations do not apply. We have developed our own Fidabio simulation model. In the model, we utilize the size of the protein of interest, the size of the protein of interest bound to the PROTAC, which can be measured independently by the Fida 1. By knowing the hydrodynamic radius of these components, we can calculate fraction of protein of interest bound in the ternary complex, positive and negative cooperativity, dissociation constants between the protein of interest and the PROTAC, dissociation constants between the PROTAC and the E3, and size of the ternary complex.
As we have shown, the Fida 1 sets new standards for characterization of PROTACs and the formation of ternary complexes. This allows you to select the best PROTACs for development.